please welcome onto the stage your chairman, Mr. Steve Parish.
Reflect on the campaign.
I don't want it to end. The way we're playing, I'd like to keep going.
Okay, now on the pitch has been exciting towards the end of the season, but the last time I saw you, we were on the steps of Croydon Town Hall after we got the planning permission for the new stand. How excited are you about that?
Tremendously excited. I think it's just a massive, massive step forward for the club. When I arrived, you know, I had a few ambitions getting into the Premier League, but improving our stadium was a must for me. So I'm absolutely, you know, ecstatic that we've got that planning permission, and now I'm looking forward to building it.
Going back to the on-field matters, it's obviously, as you said, been up and down this season. How excited and pleased are you to have Roy Hodgson back here at the helm? Because of course, he's South London's finest.
I don't know, what do we think of Roy Hodgson?
Somebody who supported the club when he was, I mean, when none of us were here, I have to say. You know, he stood on the terraces when we were in a playoff for the third division or something, he told me. So to have somebody from the local area managing the team just so fantastically well was a dream come true. It's fantastic.
Ladies and gentlemen, Steve Parish. Please welcome onto the stage our assistant manager, Ray Lewington. Welcome, Ray. How does it feel to be back at Crystal Palace Football Club?
It's very good. It's been a really, really exciting season. Probably, I've been in this game a long time. This is easily one of my favourite seasons, as it turned out. We played some great stuff, and so relieved at the end to get the points to secure our place.
The goals have been spread around the team quite a bit this season, haven't they?
That's the good thing. Relied on any one person. They've all chipped in with their goals, got them from midfield, from set pieces. Everyone's chipped in as a good team should do.
Could you please reveal the winner of the goal of the season?
Okay, this guy has been absolutely magnificent this year, and I do happen to agree that the best goal of the season is Luka against Southampton.
But to be honest, I think we scored a few much nicer goals than mine. But thank you anyway, thank you, I appreciate it.
Modest as ever, well, you guys did vote for it as your goal of the season. Have you got a message for the fans that voted?
For the fans' message, you've been amazing. Thank you for your support during the season, and you've been really amazing.
Ladies and gentlemen, one of our own, manager Roy Hodgson.
Roy, that was quite the reception there, and truly deserved. How are you feeling this week? The objective is complete. You must be feeling incredible.
Yes, been a long journey, and I've really enjoyed it, and I've worked hard to get where we are, and I'm delighted really for everybody in the club, you know, from the chairman, the board of directors, all the people who work with me, my staff, my first staff, the medical staff, everyone that comes done a fantastic job, and of course, most of all the players, because they're the ones who come to watch, and they've really done a fantastic job, and you've done a fantastic job for them, and you've backed us even through the bad times, and I'm very pleased to see Ray. That's a good time.
And Roy,
this is the next extra pressure of having such a good season back in your hometown of Croydon?
Yes, indeed. It's the particular coming here tonight is really special for me because I drove past my house in Sydenham Road. I drove up the road. I walked to school every day to East Croydon Station to catch the bus. And although things have changed quite a lot in the landscape, it brought back many memories of my childhood and my early years here in Croydon. It's been special to come back and be given a job at Crystal Palace, and it's been extra special for me this year because we've overcome all the odds and we've stayed in the league, and now we need to work hard to make certain we stay in the league next year and hopefully with a few less heartaches and problems along the way.
So without further ado, we can't be waiting any longer. Roy, please reveal this year's Player of the Season.
Well, this year's Player of the Season, he really does deserve it, is Wilf Zaha.
Boxpark, Roy Hodgson, and your Player of the Season, Wilf Zaha. Come on, Brighty.
That's a dramatic entrance if ever I saw one. Shall we just have a look? What do we think of the white trousers, first of all? Mark, it's been a hugely successful season for the Academy once again. What's been the secret?
Ooh, hard work. Obviously, Pat McCarthy's with the 18s, Richard Shaw and Dave Benson with the 23s. They've both had successful seasons, they're both in their leagues, and we've had players come through. Obviously, don't want to mention any names.
Well, without further ado, I know you were all itching to find out the winner. Please reveal the winner, Mark.
The Crystal Palace Young Player of the Year 2017-18 is Aaron Wan-Bissaka.
Aaron, I know you can't stop talking. Can we get your reaction to winning the award?
I'm overwhelmed with this trophy that I've received. I just want to thank everyone for giving me the opportunity and the chance and believing in me.
Well, thanks, Aaron. Ladies and gentlemen, Young Player of the Season! Mark Bright and Aaron Wan-Bissaka. Now we turn our attention to the Crystal Palace ladies team and yet another hugely successful season for them. The manager, Team Davenport! It's been amazing, a season of amazing progress for Palace Ladies again this season. Just talk us through it.
Yeah, it's been fantastic this year, to be fair. The progress that's been made has been absolutely great. Last season, at this time, this stage of the season, we was fifth in the league. We currently lie second after last night's win away for Coventry. So, there shows your progression straight away. We're 15 points more than what we had last year. So yeah, we've been flying at the moment.
Before you announce who's won the Player of the Year, tell us why this person has won it.
This player has won this award because she's been a nice assistant. She's a leader on and off the pitch, and she's very, very professional in what she does. So I'm really pleased that this player's won this award, and she really deserves it.
Without further ado, can you please let the crowd know who is the ladies' player of the season?
It's Freya Holdaway.
Boxpark, a round of applause for Freya Holdaway and Dean Davenport.